Hey everyone, it's Sean. At this point, I wanted to do a second tutorial, and I wanted to call it kind of designing to a grid using a graphic design principle, which is, pretty simple. It takes a while to understand and use it really well and to begin to kind of exploit what a grid can do for you. But if you're just a graphic designer starting out, or you've been working for a little while, but you want to take your work to the next level and you haven't been working with a grid before, then this is where I suggest you go. And I've got an InDesign page here that I've created just really quickly at 8.5 by 11. It's a horizontal view, so 11 by 8.5. And I've put a black background in to demonstrate these lines that I've got, which are guidelines that are across the page. And it's dividing the page into thirds. So you can see that there's three squares going across and there's three squares going down. And that's a grid. And this other page, I've got five lines going across and five lines going down. Threes and fives create kind of what are considered magic intersections. So where all these grid lines, you can see my hand cursor here, where all these lines intersect, the theory is that these create a pleasant design location for elements on your page. And likewise, in the thirds, likewise in the thirds, where you can see these intersections of three, anything that's placed on these marks, the theory is that that makes a pleasant design. And I'll show you what I mean. If I were to take a square tool here, my rectangle tool, and let's just say I were to use this spot to create the square. Let me just hide the lines for a moment. The theory is that because this is resting on that mark where two of the thirds are intersecting, that this is a pleasing place on the page, as opposed to a slightly random place. So you could argue that you may prefer this location to that location. And we're talking about one square on a page, so it's not really a demonstration of the whole rule, but I'm going to get to that. But the point is that, yeah, you could argue that any spot on a page could become a pleasing design if you use it properly. But what I'm talking about here is a grid as a place to start, as a way to kind of help you design your page with a concept in mind, a design concept, that is. And so whatever hits those intersections is considered a good point of interest. And the same goes for the fifths. And I'll do the same little exercise here. I'll just randomly pick one and put it there. I'll make it white so you can see. And you can see that it's right on the intersection of these, of the second grid lines of each direction. And if I hide this, once again, that is considered by design principle to be a more pleasing place than a random location, say like this. Now you can see that when I turn the grids back on, that I'm close to one of these spots almost anywhere on the page. There's a spot nearby. But that's not really what the whole rule is. It kind of suggests that things that match those lines in some way is a pleasing place that looks less random than, say, just right there. You can see that threes and fifths also work in both ways. So if I have a thirds across, five down, five across, three down, it still works. And the way that I get these lines, I'll just kind of quickly show you here. I'm going to delete these two guidelines. Basically, the way you do this, just a little technical side note here, I'm going to calculate here 11 divided by 3. And that gives me a number 3.666 and so on, but I'm going to call that 3.67. You could also call it 3.7, but I like to give it 1 point in just to get a little more fine-tuned. So 3.67, so if I drag a guideline across to 3.67, I may have to fine-tune that with my palette here. Let me just do that. So 3.67, and then I go back to my calculator and I multiply that by 2 to give me the second intersection, which would be 7.333, so on. I'll call that 7.34. Come back and I'm going to find 7.34, which actually is exactly there. And that's sort of how you do it. And then you can do that for any page size. It doesn't matter, a square page, a horizontal page, a 728 by 90 pixel banner. Doesn't matter. You can divide it into thirds and fifths either way. If something's really narrow, you can see that you might not want to do fifths. If that's too many lines, you might choose thirds. But the principle is still the same. It works no matter what your page size is. And I want to show you a little bit about how that works. I've just created this quick little fake page here. Graphic design isn't just an art, it's a way of life. Now you could argue that this is a nice design or not, But I would argue that it is a design based on a grid, which is a really good starting place. And whether or not this is necessarily your cup of tea as a layout, what I will argue for is the fact that it seems to have a logic behind it. And that logic is coming from using the grid as a starting point. And what I've done here, again, if you can see my hand cursor here, kind of where isn't and way meet, right in between there, there's an intersection point. Now what I've done is I've taken one intersection on the page. You see that not everything is necessarily lined up with every intersection on the page. That's not really what the rule is about. The rule is about using one of those intersection points as either a starting point, or you could use all the intersection points if you had some crazy design in mind where, you know, you're going to put objects on every one of those intersections and you're going to divide your page up into some interesting way. Sure, you could do that. But for the purpose of this rule, I'm just demonstrating that I'm using this intersection here. The arrow points right to that intersection. The two lines of type are centered together at that intersection. And then everything kind of falls out on an angle. I've just used an angle here because I thought it was a neat one. It's a 22.5 degree rotation, which is half of 45 degrees. And I've used this intersection point simply as a way to place something on the page and kind of give it a place to go. And rather, if I had just, say for example, move this stuff over, actually I didn't mean to grab the background there, but it's giving me some trouble here, there we go. Say if I just move this stuff over to some random place on the page. That doesn't look bad. I mean, you could argue that, actually I was pretty close to some intersection points anyway, but you could say that this is an interesting page layout as well. But this one seems to follow kind of a structure a little more, at least to my eye, and you can decide whether you agree or not, but you can see that if you use the grid as a starting place, it gives you something to work from, which is really quite interesting. So I've given myself this blank page here just to kind of demonstrate by design, creating a page quickly, sort of what I mean. If any of you have watched any Bollywood films, you might know who this is, Aishwarya Rai. She's an Indian actress. And argued as being possibly one of the most beautiful women to ever live, which I do not disagree with. She is, of course, stunning. So it makes it kind of fun for me, but that's really all. So anyway, what I'm going to do is you can see here, if you can see on your screen, where I've got this intersection point where my hand cursor is right now, there's an intersection of thirds right there. And I'm going to just put her photo right between her eyes, right where I want your gaze to go is going to be right on that thirds. And just for the sake of design, I'm going to crop this this in. And I don't know what, I'm going to make up some headline here, but let's say that my headline is "Beauty is more than skin deep." Oop, not skin depth, not Johnny Depp. But I'll pick some random font, just say Helvetica New, oh, I don't know, 67 medium condensed. Let's just say that's my font. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to use this grid line as well. And you can see that I'm going to center the type. Actually, something interesting is kind of happening as I do that. I've centered the type on this grid line where my hand is kind of going here. There's a grid line there, and I've centered the type. And what it's done is, because I'm using this line of thirds, actually, I'm going to cheat this over a bit. So, I mean, you know, again, the rule can be broken to some degree. So I'm going to nudge that over, and I'm just going to, for fun, make this type white so it shows up through her hair. And so I've got this little page layout now. Beauty is more than skin deep. And it lines up with her eyes, which I think is a nice design trick, because it kind of, the typography leads right into her gaze, which is kind of a neat thing. And I've used the lines of thirds to create this really simple page layout. But you can see from this that there's some sense of structure to it. There's a feeling that these things belong where they are. And I might even be able to get away with moving this one down let's just say I pull them back, I could argue now that this is also good. So beauty is more than skin deep, lines up to the bottom row of thirds. Now it's only just design accident, which is a happy thing, that it lines up with her watch, which kind of gives us this little triangle of design from the type through to the watch here, which kind of goes up on an angle to her eyes and creates this little triangle, which is kind of a nice design accident that happens every once in a while. So whether or not you agree that this is a beautiful layout or not, you can see that from the thirds and fifths, you can really start to design something that looks dynamic on the page. Things aren't centered. They have a different way of relating to one another. But it's kind of an interesting energy that gets created by these thirds and fifths. So if you can kind of understand what I'm getting at, then your next page layout, give it a try. Divide your page up. Use it as a guideline and start creating in thirds and fifths. And anyway, love to hear what you have to say about this, whether you agree or disagree, make your comments. And if there's anything that you'd like me to cover specifically, if you kind of like my way of seeing things, then just pop a note into this video and I'll be happy to address it in another video. But I hope you've enjoyed this. Thirds and fifths, grid design theory, if you will. And hope to see you back again. Thanks.